5 सेकेंड, 2 सेकेंड, रेडी। द अप्लियंट एंड द रेस्पोंडेंट एंटर्ड इनटू एन एग्रीमेंट फॉर सेल ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टी इन डिस्प्यूट ऑन 21st of December 2005 फॉर अ सम ऑफ रुपीज 6,99,000 इन विच एन एडवांस ऑफ रुपीज 20,000 वॉज पेड टू द रेस्पोंडेंट एट द टाइम ऑफ एग्जीक्यूटिंग द एग्रीमेंट फॉर सेल। वन ऑफ द स्टिपुलेशन इन द एग्रीमेंट फॉर सेल वॉज दैट द बैलेंस अमाउंट ऑफ द कंसिडरेशन मनी शैल बी पेड टू द रेस्पोंडेंट एट द टाइम ऑफ रजिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ द सेल डीड विच शैल बी एग्जीक्यूटेड विद इन 60 days फ्रॉम द डेट ऑफ एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ द एग्रीमेंट फॉर सेल। The agreement for sale specifically mentioned that it was the obligation of the respondent to keep the title good till the execution and registration of the sale deed and further to keep the property in dispute free from all encumbrances of charges. It was also agreed that the respondent shall pay all rates, taxes and cesses in regard to the property in dispute up to the date of sale and all dues prior to the sale deed. It was further agreed that in case of dispute, the same should be referred to arbitration under the provisions of Arbitration and Conciliation Act 1998, in short the Act. The respondent borrowed funds from KSDC and various other financial institutions for installation of various kinds of machineries in the factory, thereby created equitable mortgage by way of deposit of title deeds with various financial institutions. It was clearly understood that at the time of registration of the sale deed, vacant and peaceful physical possession of property in dispute would be delivered by the respondent to the appliant and that the respondent would be bound to remove all plants and machineries from their factory in order to deliver possession to the appliant after clearing all its dues to the various financial institutions and keep the title deed ready for the purpose of execution of the sale deed. The appliant started doubting its bona fide and therefore by a letter notice date 18th of February 2006 called upon the respondent to execute the sale deed so that the vacant possession of the property in dispute could be delivered to him. On 20th of February 2006, the appliant received a letter from the respondent asking him to complete the sale transaction on the very next day, that is on 21st of February 2006. After the receipt of the letter mentioned above, the appliant approached the respondent and requested the respondent to perform their part of the obligation. The respondent assured the appliant that they would require some more time to remove the machineries from the property in dispute as they were in large numbers and very huge in size. They also informed the appliant that they required some more time to make alternative arrangement of other premises where their plants and machineries could be kept as they were very expensive and involved a lot of money. As the appliant had already paid an amount of rupees 200,000 to the respondent, he had no choice but to keep quiet.